Hello, daughter.
You ain't my mother.
You did not come out of my womb. But when you placed your virginity on God's doorstep, I knew someone had to teach you that sometimes blood is not thicker than water. And when I see your face from my window pane, it reflects the image of my own shame.
Because of your past, Laura, that does not make me your daughter. For you killed your future son or daughter. In my world, I beg that you come no further because you lost the chance of being my mother.
I don't come to enter your world, but to pull you out and lead you into a world that can make you complete. For you, woman of the street, don't choose to accuse me, but in good faith, learn to trust me. Because though you choose the street, I have chosen to believe.
No, woman of spiritual belief, you chose to believe while I was given the street. And now you come as if you are threaded together by
my pain and your pain has
now become symmetrical. Your hand is no cleaner than mine. The transparency of light, has illuminated our darkness.
In you, I see my past.
But in you, I don't see my future.
I understand your resistance, because daily you question your existence. It wasn't too long ago that I too had the residue of breast milk still encrusted above my lips. I was only 13 when 4 dudes climbed inside of me. See, I was only going to school when a car pulled up and said hello. I continued to walk as the men inside continued to talk, shouting, "Baby, come and make me happy. Can I be more than your sugar dad?" Only wanted to escape. Instead of finding myself face down in the dirt, Lord, why won't they stop? Why must I hurt? All over my face they began to burst, and closing my eyes and my mind, I tried to hide as each of them took turns touching me from the inside.
It was in that moment I wished I wasn't born.
And in my mind I began to scream, "Oh God, help me!" What only lasted for a couple of minutes seemed to be decades. And now, after 5 years, I'm faced with having AIDS. It wasn't enough for them to mess up my insides, but they also took my dignity. So later I declared that they would never be able to control my fate. Yet still, for them I pray, that for them it's not too late. And Lord, in hell, let them not have a resting place.
You hide behind your divinity. But you still haven't given me a reason of why you killed your only baby.
I was only 13. I was not suckling on an old teenage love story. For I was still at the age of combing Barbie's hair and playing with mother's lipstick. I was too young to allow my heart to pump heavy with mistakes. As I grew older, the fingerprint of my fetus being slaughtered stayed imprinted on my soul. For I was just a little girl.
Yes, we were just little girls.